Good evening. How's everybody doing tonight? Good, good. Got something special for you. You know, Tad didn't set out to produce the Pittsburgh Cycle. Rather, in 2003, Leonard Piggy, founder and director of Honolulu African American Repertory Theater Group, approached Tag's managing director, Frankie Enos, about producing Two Trains Running. Now, Leonard explained how he'd been to every house all over town with absolutely no luck until he stumbled across a tiny yellow brick studio located in Kakarako. Tag went on to produce Two Trains Running. That show sold out the tiny 40-seat house on Kayabe Street, and the rest, as they say, is history. From that moment on, Tag had a mission to produce the Pittsburgh Cycle. Tag achieved that mission when they produced My Room's Black Bottom in April of 2015.
That introduced Tag to August Wilson, and we want to give him much mahalo for that. And also, Tag is the only theater in Hawaii that has done all 10 of the August Wilson plays. We'd like to give him a hand for that.
Similarly, August Wilson didn't have this grand idea in his back pocket either. First, he wrote Jitney, set in 1977, then went on to write Ma Rainey's Black Bottom, set in 1927. It was after Ma Rainey's Black Bottom, August Wilson knew he was on a mission.
Together in the City of Bones again. Mm-hmm. Who thought?
I know.
Is it beautiful the first time you saw it?
Just as bright, as beautiful as it ever was.
Oh, I'm glad. I'm glad. So you just make yourself at home.
I'm going to go let Black Mary know that I seen you.
Yes. You're going to be here a long time. Mary, come on, honey.
Hi, Aunt Esther.
How you doing?
I'm looking for Floyd.
Yes, I know. I can tell by looking on your face. You're looking for Floyd. He's here, honey. But you got to remember, there's a people up here. So you'll find him. Don't worry about it. Don't worry. Keep us on the mind. There you go. Go ahead.
Thank you, Aunt Esther.
Yeah, it's okay. Ma ran in. Where you at, Mama?
How you doing?
How you doing, baby?
Oh, love it.
Beautiful. Beautiful. Yes, sir. We're going to gather everybody here because we're
going
to welcome somebody very special. Okay. Yeah. Yeah, so we are going to welcome him doing the Juba.
Okay.
Now, those of you who don't understand, I'm going to explain. Juba is a dance from Africa, and it's a dance of celebration. Like I say, when a family member comes home after a long trip, do the Juba, welcome back. When the man of the village went to hunt, and they had a successful hunt, did the Juba to welcome him back. So that's what we're going to do here now. And those of you who know the song we're about to sing, y'all just go ahead and join in. You just start off, Mom. Go ahead. Go ahead.
In the water, way in the water, children wait in the water. God's gonna trouble the water. Wait in the water. Wait in the water, children wait in the water.
Now you Make Daddy come.
Mr. Wilson, when you get cold here in the city of Bones, I forgot your coat here. Keep it warm. There you go.
Father Wilson, I got your hat here.
Okay. And you know you got to have a cigarette.
Can't smoke without.
And you can't have smokes without matches.
That's right.
And here's a little something to catch those ashes, Mr. Wilson.
All right. You know what else you got. You know what else you need. Go ahead. Yes, sir.
Got you a glass, Mr. Wilson.
Ooh, yes, yes.
I'll pour it, Mr. Wilson. Ooh.
Huh? You want more?
Yes.
Make it double that man's drink.
August! I got a napkin for you!
It's okay, Gabriel.
It's your favorite pen.
Come on, baby.
And you're gonna need this portrait there if you keep your dog sitting and write your next place.
This is a number 2 pencil and it has an eraser too.
You comfortable now? I'm glad you are now. Like I said, these are children. They want to talk to you because they got questions that only you can answer. Moved north, just came up here to Pittsburgh, Pennsylvania, moved into corner where I found him. All right, you the daddy. Y'all been asking a question. I said, just come over here and start washing something. Don't get that one. Oh, goodness.
Too. So many people left by the freedom.
Gem of the Ocean begins it all. It was set in Aunt Esther Tyler's parlor in Pittsburgh's Hill District at 1839 Wiley Avenue. The year was 1904. A young man named Citizen Barlow had committed a crime, and he has come to Aunt Esther to get his soul washed. Upon seeing him, Aunt Esther was reminded of her son, Junebug, who was lynched. Also visiting was Solly Two Kings carrying his stick on the way down south to bring up folks to the north. This time, he's bringing up his sister, Eliza Jackson. Unfortunately, this would be Mr. Two King's final trip. Gem of the Ocean was the second Wilson play that Tag produced in his new Chinatown Theater in 2010. So many people led by the bondage, led by the stick. In a way, this stick represents freedom. A good man once told me, you keep a good stick, it'll keep the trouble away. Now you take this. You protect it, and it'll protect you too. Good luck in the travels.
Joe Turner's Come and Gone is a drama of indisputable greatness and considered by many to be August Wilson's masterpiece. Tag's production was directed by actor and director Russell Mottern. Russell teaches Black history at Iolani School. During the run, the eminent Black historian John Pope Franklin was in Honolulu for lectures, and Russ invited him and his family to the show. They came and spoke with the audience afterwards. Joe Turner introduced Jim Andrews to Tag.
Joe Turner's Come and Gone is set in 1911 in Seth Hawley's boarding house in Pittsburgh's Hill District. Travelers coming up from the south pass through the boarding house. In his prologue, Wilson writes of the arrival of former slaves to the urban north, foreigners in a strange land, isolated, cut off from memory, forgetting the names of their gods and only guessing at their faces. But Seth Hawley is not from the South. He was born in the North, a free man, and he wants no trouble in his house. When Harold Loomis appears with his daughter, Zonia, Seth senses big trouble. Mr. Wilson, how you doing, sir? Harold Loomis. You know, sir, we all gathered here in this here city of bone, I think they call it. Everything all happy and light. I seen packs of people walking around saying, everybody's supposed to be content. Well, Mr. Wilson,
I'm sorry to have to be here to tell you. I don't share that emotion. You see, so when you gave me life back in 1911, you made it so that I lived from that time right on up until today. That took me through the Middle Passage, right on up until today. I done seen a lot of pain, Mr. Wilson. Can't seem to shake it. You know, I've been walking the earth what seemed like forever, trying to reconnect this here baby with her mom. So now I figure what I...
Want to come and play?
Figure when I find her mama to help me reconnect myself. You know, Mr. Wilson, many of these folks out here don't know who Joe Turner was. And see, Joe Turner was a real person. He's a brother of the governor of the great state of Tennessee. And you know what his job was? He's a plantation. Slave owner. Had connections in the town. This man, on any given weekend, had been arrested for no reason. Crossing the street, playing an illegal card game. Next morning, go outside, be 40 or 50 niggas lined up in chains and shackles, being marched on out. Families ripped apart. Now you see, I was a regular family man. Had a nice family, was a prominent deacon in the Abundant Life Church. People come to me for advice, money. After a weekend when Mr. Joe Turner come, baby's mama's sisters wake up in the morning, daddy's gone. Older brother's gone. Baby say, what happened? Mama say, Joe Turner done come and gone. I tell you, Mr. Wilson, I know I sliced myself across my chest trying to get the demons out of my body. I done had all these people think I was crazy. Break out in fits. I ain't crazy, Mr. Wilson. Just seeing a lot of pain. Even today, Mr. Wilson, young man's supposed to be protected by the police. Get shot in the back for no reason. Ain't nobody got nothing to say. Don't ever find who did it. That's the kind of pain I've been living with for the past 300 years. Can't get close to nobody. You know, I go a lot of places, traveling around this whole country, meet some people that I wish I could get closer to. Don't nobody want a man to wake up screaming in the middle of the night. Take this here matter camera. Now she a right fine looking woman. Firm backside, baby naked hips. I wouldn't even know what to say to her though. Tormented man like me. Miss Maddie, you know I ain't too good with words, but I was wondering if I could maybe find the words to ask you to walk on down the road with me a bit.
You don't want to go nowhere with that man. That man crazy.
You mean crazy, Mr. Holly?
Come up my house acting like a fool. That's what I'm talking about.
See, Mr. Holly here from the north.
That's right.
You ain't never seen a man hung from a tree with his foot cut off because he tried to escape. You ain't never seen mamas ripped from, babies ripped from their mama's breast crying. You ain't never heard the screaming of a woman being raped by a slave master. You can't do nothing but stand there and watch it. No, I ain't crazy. I ain't crazy at all. I just wear this pain for my entire life, just like I wear this coat. Can't shake it. Terrible thing. Feel like I'm going crazy.
Did you really see all those things you said you saw?
Yes, ma'am, I did.
Well, I don't think you're crazy. I don't think you're crazy one bit. That can make anybody seem a little crazy. No, you. You're a strong man. Because it takes a strong man to go through what you went through. You don't have to be in pain anymore.
I went downtown to get my grip. I came back home just to pull my skip, just to pull my skip. I went upstairs to make my bed. I made a mistake and bumped my head, just to pull my skip, just to pull my skip. I went downstairs to milk my cow. I made a mistake and milked that sow. Just to pull my skip, just to pull my skip. Tomorrow never comes.
Is to get her voice recorded so they can make some money off her. Ma will make certain that they do it on her terms. If I should take a notion and jump into the ocean, ain't nobody's business.
That was sweet.
Sweet.
Just like your shoes.
You and them $4 shoes. Really?
You crazy old woman. You don't know what you're talking about.
Man, don't make me pull off my skirt and put my shirt on and whoop your ass like your mama should.
Hey, y'all, you go again. With all that bickering.
He needs to learn his place. It's called my place.
Oh, excuse me, ma'am. I forgot we are still on the slave plantation.
It ain't got nothing to do with the slave plantation.
This Mars band.
Thank you.
Supposed to be playing Mars music.
He don't know.
Oh, excuse me, step and fetch it.
Step and fetch it.
I'm sorry, a slow drag. I forgot. You still the same old simple country nigga you always been.
See, didn't I tell
you? Sitting in the back.
Didn't I tell you?
Doing what you told.
He ain't doing
not
anything.
Not me, slow drag.
Respectful. Something you need to learn.
When have you ever showed respect for anything?
Nigga, I gave you a job. How you think you got them $4 shoes?
Maybe you think that's all about.
Maybe you spend more time worrying about your music instead of messing around with your stupid ass shoes. Why, you want to make something with yourself?
You think we should play the same old jug band music we've been playing?
You play the music that I say you play. That's why it's called Ma Rainey's Black Box. I beg your pardon? What? Say.
Maybe we should ask Mr. Wilson, see what he thinks.
Fine. Move away, son. Hey, August. How you doing? So glad to see you. one question. Why me? Out of all the blues singers that you put here, why you choose me? Oh, really? Well, thank you. You know I love you too. You know I ain't no fictitious character. You ain't made me about your mind.
Oh, we all real, baby.
I'm real.
Some of you are real. I just want to say thank you, August. I appreciate what you've done for me. I'm glad out of all your plays, I'm really real.
Thank you.
And I love you too. I want you on here.
Mr. Wilson, I want to thank you for making me so pretty. You did an exceptional job, if I do say so myself. And thank you for giving me such divine musical talent. When I have this horn in my hand, I feel like the Archangel Gabriel. Play the trumpet for the good Lord.
You lucky you up here in the city of Bones. You should be burning right now.
In hell.
Well, thank you, Mr. Wilson. But tell me, brother, why did you put me with this crazy old woman?
So you'd learn some manners. So you'd learn some respect. So I don't have to whoop your ass in public.
Mr. Wilson, not only will she not let my music get heard, but when I'm on stage, I can't be seen behind her big black bottom.
That's probably because you want some of this. You know I go both ways.
That's all right. I think your woman was plenty enough for me.
Baby, bitches is $5 a minute.
Yeah, I didn't need $5 to get it.
You ain't $5.
I'm not fussing with each other. It's a miracle we ever got anything.
You need to learn his place.
My place.
Your place. You don't understand who I am.
Mr. Wilson,
I don't thank you.
Why can't these two fools see the thing? They two sides of the same coin. I mean, shit. They even trying to mess with the same woman. Why can't they just play the music like it's supposed to be played? Yeah, Mr. Wilson, in harmony. We in the city of Bones now.
You know.
Things can be different here. You ain't gonna be carrying all that anger and hostility towards each other anymore. Lucky, this is Ma's band.
Thank you.
You respect that. She know what she's doing. She got a formula at work.
Hey.
Ma, I know I love you, but Levy, you don't know what Levy's gone through to get here.
For sure.
He didn't walk the long road, Ma.
Just
like you did.
And I love you too.
Why can't we just play the music like Mr. Wilson and Tim in harmony, together?
Christ, Soldier, it's always been about the music for me.
My man ain't got no money. Mm. And I say take all my money. Ain't nobody's business if I do. If I go to church on Sunday and shimmy down all day Monday. Ain't nobody's business if I do. If I do. Nobody's business. Ain't nobody's business. Nobody's business if I do.
With this production of Piano Lesson in 2010, Tag was halfway through the Pittsburgh cycle. It was the second and the last of Wilson plays produced at a theater in Chinatown. The Piano Lesson centers on the conflicts between siblings, a brother and sister. Boy Willie, a sharecropper, wants to sell the family's heirloom piano in order to buy the land he and his ancestors has worked on for generations. His sister Bernice refuses to sell the precious instrument because it is carved with the faces of their forebears. Piano Lesson is rich in passion, humor, and song. It is haunted by the ghost that shakes the house and the very souls of its inhabitants.
Bernice! Oh. Girl, I am happy to see you.
Stop sleeping up on me.
Oh, girl, I mean that bad.
Have you been around this whole place, Bernice?
Not all of it, but it's huge.
This place is humongous.
I know. Gorgeous.
You know,
here too.
Oh, you did?
I sure did! And I made peace with you too. I made peace with you, but you know what bothers me? Is that I don't feel like I made peace with you, Bernice. I'm sorry, you know I didn't mean nothing bad.
Oh, boy, Willie, I forgive you.
Good.
What? We're in a city of bones. Yeah. Everything is forgiven.
It's nice here, isn't
it? Oh.
<It's> like... You know, Bernice, have you ever thought who owns this place?
Why, well, really, nobody owns it. It belongs to everybody.
Yeah, you're going to be in and out of here again. Somebody owns this place. This place is too big.
Nobody, except nobody owns it.
I think I have an idea who owns it, too. But I think he's mad at me because I can't find anyone around here I'm looking for.
Have you seen him? Who are you talking about?
I see all our ancestors except Dad.
He's here.
Bernice, I haven't seen him anywhere. I think he's mad at me, so he ain't showing himself to me or something.
Oh, Willie, you're not looking hard enough.
Where is he then?
Boy, Willie, he's sitting right there.
Where, Bernice? I don't see anybody there.
Well, Willie, he's sitting right here.
Bernice, you always had that gift to see the spirits. I can't see nothing.
You've always been blessed with second sense, but why, Willie, you need to look at him. He's right there.
Bernice, come over here. Come over here. Come on over here.
What?
Since you can see him, can you do me a favor?
What is it, boy, Willie?
You're my sister, right? We family.
Uh-huh.
Okay, good. Could you ask him if I can have maybe about 4 or 5 acres? I want to build something around here. I don't know what I want to build yet, but I'm going to build something. I mean, plant something, you know. Can you do that for me?
Why don't you just go over there and talk to the man?
Bernice, you don't seem to be listening. I can't see the man. Why don't you go over there and say something to me? I'll be over there.
You know your pain, but I know. Jeez. Hello, Father Wilson. It's me, Bernice. Well, it's nice to see you again, too. But I'm here to ask a question. Not on my behalf, but of Boy Willie. Oh, you know him. He's so stubborn. He wants me to... But... Hey, I'll tell him, but... Like I said, he's stubborn.
Bernice, come on.
Boy,
any success?
He wants you to talk to him.
What?
Come. He wants me to tell you.
Bernice, how can I talk to somebody I
don't know? Shut up and go over there and talk to the man. Mm-hmm. Just stand there. Concentrate.
Sir, my name is Boy Willis. I just want to say you got a nice, mighty fine place around here. It's pretty big, too. You probably can stand to get rid of at least 5 acres. I was with... Bernice, did you just feel that?
I felt it.
Is that what that feels like? Bernice, I think I got your illness. I think I heard him say yes. He said yes, Bernice! I'm gonna give my acres! My acres of forever! Oh, man. Well, what am I gonna be? I'm gonna be something. Thank you.
Father Wilson wants me to give you the stick. He says, take this stick, turn your soil.
At least I'm going to turn. I don't know what you're talking about.
Just concentrate. Why, Willie? Remember Berna.
Oh!
Oh! part did I play? I mean, you made me a champion for young women, and yet you gave me Ruby's boy King to raise, and what kind of an example was I for him? I did my best by that boy, though. But I do have a question for you, Mr. Wilson. August, I need to ask you something. What real woman or women in your life did I emulate? Because I am way too real to be a figment of your imagination. Seven Guitars was the first Wilson play Tag produced in the Dole Cannery Square. It was directed by Frankie Enos, James Harper, and seven very talented guitars. Seven Guitars introduced Mark Cooper to theater and to tag. Set in 1948, Seven Guitars started out in Wilson's head with seven bluesmen who set out to tell the story of blues guitarist Floyd Martin's life. Then, according to the playwright, suddenly a woman walked onto the stage. When August Wilson asked her what she wanted, she said,
"Mr. Wilson, I want my own space."
"You mean," Wilson asked, "you want your own scene?"
"No, sir, I want my own space."
August Wilson closed his notebook for 2 months. When he opened it again, there on the blank page was Vera Dixon. And once he allowed her in, two other women, Louise and Ruby, came in behind her.
A veteran returning home from World War II, Floyd Barton has come home to find that nothing has changed for the black man in America. Bigotry and injustice, together with his own actions, lead to a tragic ending. Seven Guitars shows us the African-American ability to absorb and not be broken. August Wilson once said, "One must be hopeful." Vera Dixon, look at you. Ain't you a sight for sore eyes? Louise?
Hi, Floyd. I missed you.
I was missing you, too. I was missing you so bad, I was feeling empty inside.
Don't believe him, Vera.
Well, you must not have missed me too much because you took someone else with you to Chicago.
We sure did.
I wanted to go, Floyd.
There y'all go, too, again. Go again. Bringing her up.
You should have waited for me. I just need a little more time.
I told you she was a nobody. I didn't have no time, Vera.
You should have waited.
Record executives want me to come out there and record them hits. We made some good songs.
Yeah, right.
Tell me more about Chicago. What did it look like?
Chicago was perfect.
Yeah.
They got buildings that reach way up into the clouds.
And the streets, were they tiny and narrow, big and wide?
They got them big old wide avenues. Cadillacs and Fords flying all up and down the road. You can barely cross the street without getting hit by one.
One of them should have hit you.
That's why you ain't got no man. Maybe all right. If you stop running your mouth all the time, I'll get you a man and not a broomstick.
What about music? Did you listen to some good music?
They had music like I ain't never heard before. I seen Mr. Muddy Waters playing out there at the Hurricane Club. I told myself, I'm gonna learn to play music like that one day.
And the ladies, how the ladies look?
They look beautiful. They had long, flowing, silky dresses on.
You ought to know, you probably got under enough of them.
They didn't look as pretty as you did in that pink and blue dress you had on when I first seen you.
Yeah, I remember that dress. Mr. Wilson, you hear this toppling Negro? He got a pretty voice and a pretty face. But Floyd didn't realize all he needed was the love of a good woman. The love of a good woman. Floyd could have been anybody. He could have done anything. Floyd, do you love me as much as you love your music?
Of course I do, Vera.
No, he doesn't.
Mr. Wilson, why can't she see that? Why can't she see that I love her? It's the love I got for her that pushes this music out of me. I couldn't make no music without the way I feel about her. The spark in your eyes sets my soul on fire. Your voice is like an angel above.
That's why you should stick to the guitar.
Touching your hand drives me insane. Baby, I want to be loved. I'm crazy about every little thing that you do. I cherish the way that you hug. Your kiss is so sweet, honey. Can't be beat. But baby, I want to be loved. Every time I ask you on a date, you don't come at all, though you're mighty late. I ask you to dance a little spin. You say, wait a minute, daddy, here comes my friend.
Oh, I heard. But it would not say, you said, I'm sure I'll be a big man one day. Oh, I thought I heard, but it would not say, you said, I'm a lot of money, king, I'll take it away.
Take it away? Take it away like you took my money?
That's right, brother.
Took my money?
Just like I took your money. Remember the last time you see me with this, and it worked out so good for you, don't did it?
No.
But the boy that gave me that money promised me that he'd give it to me. That was my money, you get in my way. So now you know what happens when you get in my way. Out here talking about all your music things.
That was my money, I earned it.
You want it back? I didn't think so. You're out here talking about your dreams and playing music. If you want to play music, take your ass on to Chicago or wherever it is you go. And you, the love of a good man, you had a good man right in front of you and you throw it all away. But
here in the city of Bones now, come to terms with all that.
I have a new perspective. Don't cut people with my machete no more. All I do is tend to my garden and sing my song. Life is good now. You know that I don't do that no more, right? Come over here, man, I can't hear you.
Nope, okay.
You know I don't do that no more here in the city of Bones.
Yes.
Right. Well, man, let me hear you say it. I can't hear you!
Well, hey, I can't hear you do that no more.
I'm only kidding with you, you crazy line of being. All I'm gonna do is mess around with my daughter. Thought I heard, but it won't say yes, and soon I'll be a big man one day. Oh, I thought I heard, but it won't say yes, and
Maybe he's right. Things can be different here.
Floyd?
It don't have to be like it was back in Pittsburgh.
Well, you know, Vera, some people don't change, though.
I can't, Vera. I ain't got my feet on backwards no more.
I believe you.
You take my hand, I'll never leave your side. Come on. The spark in your eyes sets my soul on fire. Your voice is like an angel's love.
So, is this what you envision true love to look like?
You are my sunshine, my only sunshine. You make me happy.
How you do?
Fine, baby. How are you?
Is that spit for me?
I don't know. Is this stick for him? Really? You want me to give this stick to him? I guess so, baby, but what's your name?
I'm Gay Romance. What's your name?
I'm Louise.
How you doing, Louise?
I'm good, Gabriel. Now you take this here stick and you take good care of it. Now here.
Oh, okay.
Fences begins in 1957 and tells a story of Troy Maxton, son of a sharecropper father, whose failures left him violent and bitter. A great baseball player in the Negro Leagues, but age prevented Troy from playing in the majors. His brother Gabriel sustained a traumatic head injury in the Second World War, which left him permanently childlike and damaged. Because Troy takes care of his brother, Troy uses Gabriel's disability check to buy a house. Troy's young son, Corey, had been offered a college scholarship to play football, but Troy refused to allow it, despite his pleas and those of Troy's wife, Rose. Troy loses Rose's love when he fathers a child with another woman, and Rose raises Troy's baby as though she were her own. Wilson writes, "When the sins of our fathers visit us, we do not have to play host."
Give me it! Get it, Troy!
What are you doing there?
This doesn't belong to you here! What? Get off of this thing, Troy! I told you! I seen you here in the city of
Boston.
But I didn't see you like I seen everybody else.
Well, how'd you see me?
Troy?
Yeah.
I try to help you. I blow my trumpet. But nothing happened. Troy! No! Why were you so mean to me, Troy?
I never was mean.
You took my money.
I had to put the roof over your head. I put the food in your belly. Come on.
No! Give it back, Troy! This is not yours! Give it back! This... No! I told you. Your boy turned out to be such a good boy, Troy. And you left Rose with that pretty baby girl. Oh, she was so pretty. Why do you love your wife, Troy?
Gabriel, you know much better than that. Now, what are you talking
about? No!
Why?
Give it back this stick! No! Rose!
Stop.
Rose!
Gabriel!
No, Rose! Rose!
Gabriel!
Rose!
Stop that!
Rose!
Gabriel!
Rose!
Gabriel!
No!
Gabriel! Gabriel, look at me! Look at me, Gabriel!
Gabriel, Rose!
It's okay, Gabriel!
Oh, what are you doing here? Oh, my God!
Troy!
Oh,
you... No! Troy, what are you doing here? Gabriel!
Gabriel's always acting like that.
No!
Leave him alone!
What's the matter with you, Rose?
Troy!
Rose, you
know! Troy, why are you here?
I've always loved you. Come on.
You've never loved anybody but yourself, Troy. I'm here in the City of Bones. I want peace. I don't want your bitterness anymore, Troy.
Bitter? I'm not bitter. I took care of everybody in the house. What do you mean, bitter?
You didn't take care of that baby! That baby!
Rose, how'd the baby turn out? Did she grow up and go to college? Tell me about it, Rose. Did she get married? Tell me about it. What was her name?
Troy Brunel, Cookie, a fine woman, in spite of
love you.
In spite of me, what did I do? I did nothing but try to take care of my family.
You took care of us.
I took care
nobody
of
nobody but yourself. Join us, leave. Go!
We don't want you to put in this here, Troy. Just go.
Go, Troy.
Oh, please. Can I give that rose to my sister-in-law, Rose, like I used to?
Go, Troy! Go!
It's okay, little girl. It's okay.
Rose, I got a rose for you, just like the one I used to get.
Is that one of the souls I've got to wash?
I just have one question for you, Mr. Wilson. And I just want to know, Why did you make me scar up my legs? You couldn't choose any other part on my body. Not my arms, maybe my stomach. It had to be my legs, huh? So just throw out all those cute skirts and dresses I could have worn, huh? What'd you say? Okay, Mr. Wilson. Two Trains Running was a play that started all for Tag. Leonard Pigge directed it and played Memphis, owner of a diner in the Hill District, adding his beautiful singing voice to the part. Two Trains Running was especially notable for Tag because it marked the theater debut of Derrick Brown, who went on to star in three more Wilson shows and to direct Fences and Jimmy.
This train is bound for glory, this train is bound for glory, this train. It was Pittsburgh, 1969. The regulars at Memphis Lee's restaurant grappled with the obstacles that black Americans face under the rules of white America. Now the block that Memphis's diner sat on was about to be demolished, destroying not only his diner, but also the community that gathered there. Now, the rich undertaker across the street encouraged Memphis to accept a low bid offer to be bought out by the city. Memphis refused. He would hold out until the city paid him what his diner was truly worth. Now, Sterling was a young man of 30. He was out of the penitentiary for a week.
Girls, you are a sight for sore eyes, girl. Now, I know you must be tired, because you've been running through my mind all night. Girl, I mean, you look so good. Somebody ought to put you on a plate and sop you up with a biscuit. You know, I went to the doctor. Told me I need more vitamin U. Anyway, you're a sight for sore, girl. How you doing, girl?
I'm doing just fine, Sterling.
I can see that you're doing just fine. But you know, I got a question for you. You know, we was over on the other side. You had that thing. You used to cut up to your legs. Why you do that? What was going on with that leg thing?
Of course. An ignorant question for an ignorant Negro. The reason why I scarred up my legs was because I didn't want men looking at me the way that you're looking at me right now.
Oh, well, Miss Richard, please don't get it confused. You see, I'm a Christian man. So I admire the things that God makes. In fact, you could be the eighth one of the world, because, girl, you just look good. Amen. You hear this going out here talking about how she don't want people looking at her? What did you do?
Now, you done made me lose what I was trying to do. I'm trying to play some numbers.
Now,
you know how to write.
I do know how to write.
You've been in the pen.
That's all right.
I don't know how to write or not.
Well, we don't see that.
Well, do me a favor and write what I tell you.
All right.
Now, remember those numbers.
Numbers.
Yeah. 36.
36?
24.
24.
36.
Six.
You got that?
36. Let me make sure I got this right. I believe you said
36.
36.
24. 36. That's the number. That's a winning hand, I think.
How did you come up with those numbers, Memphis?
I had a dream last night. The Lord gave me these numbers in the middle of the night.
Mm-hmm. So why were you looking at me when you wrote those numbers down?
Well, you just probably just jogged memory. You have this glow about you that just helped me just to remember those numbers. So I don't know why. Maybe you were in the dream. I can't remember all of it, but I remember those numbers.
Sound like body measurements to me.
Body measurements? Where you going with that?
Speaking of numbers, you have that urban development thing going on, right?
That's right. When we were on the other side, now I remember they offered you some money and you turned it down. Then they came back with a counter offer. Now word is, you got some money.
Why y'all had to bring that up? Let's stay focused. I can't remember how much I made enough, but not enough to, that's why I'm paying these numbers.
36.
Yeah. I am more interested in those numbers. So can you read them off for me one more time, please?
I think it was 36.
No, say how you said it the first time.
Oh, 36. 2, 4, 36. I don't see anything significant about this.
It's okay, don't worry about it. Because I see exactly what you're doing. You two are the exact same way that you were at the diner. Here we are in the City of Bones, and I explained to you why I scarred my legs. And the real reason was because a woman wants some respect. But she still can't get any respect from you two. Because you two are still doing the same thing that she was doing. Now, before a woman has a body, she has a mind. And my eyes are up here, so I don't know why you're looking everywhere else every time you talk
about it. Ms. Wilson, you know what? Now that we're here in the City of Bones, and we have a different perspective, and well, I recognize we might have said some been off color and said some wrong things to you, so on behalf of me and Memphis, I'd like to apologize for what he said.
Is that true, Memphis?
Look, we all on the same train, just on a different track.
Tells the story of five men who made their living as jitney drivers, unlicensed taxi drivers working the Pittsburgh Hill District in 1977. Becker is the owner of the station. 20 years earlier, his promising young son, Booster, who excelled at science, shot and killed his wealthy white girlfriend for falsely accusing him of raping her. He served 20 years for that crime. Early in the play, discouraged and disappointed, Becker never visited him. Earlier in the play, we learned that Booster has recently been released from prison and has gone to visit his father's jitney station. Jitney marked the directorial debut of Derrick Brown and ran from February 1st to March 4th, 2007.
Why'd you kill the girl? Why'd you go over there and shoot that girl?
I had my reasons. I told you that.
You had your reason?
I had my
to kill somebody?
Yes.
Well, I want to hear it. Why?
She ruined everything that I worked for.
She did.
Everything. She lied on me.
You're blaming it on her. She pulled the trigger.
Who else am I blaming on?
Well, didn't you do it?
Did I lie on me? After that, no one was going to see me as anything else but a rapist.
Why did you have to shoot her? I could have got you off. I could have helped you.
You could not have gotten me off. Did you help me at the time?
I tried.
I know you tried. It doesn't make a difference. After she lied on me, there was no hope for me. And if I'm going to go to prison for something, it's going to be for something that I actually do.
On your turn.
on my terms. Unlike you, I'm not gonna sit by and just let things happen.
Your turn put you in prison. Your turn killed the girl.
I'm good with that.
Your turn killed your mother. You good with that? Your turn killed your mother.
Anybody killed my mother, it was you.
Officer.
You abandoned
her. Can you tell me why you wrote in my son to be a murderer? Somebody who could shoot and kill somebody and not have too much to do about it afterwards. Somebody go to prison. Somebody who killed his mother. When she heard that you gonna be in prison for life, that killed her.
Why'd you write that? Why'd you do that?
Why you took her away from me? Yeah, he went to prison, but I lost her. I lost my wife.
You lost her before that.
I lost her because of you.
That's enough.
You killed him.
Mr. Wilson, you made me so promising. I thought I was gonna uplift our race. I thought I was gonna change everything. Nothing's ever gonna change. Why did you have that white woman lie on me? She ruined everything. She made me feel worthless.
That's a good word for you, worthless. That's exactly what you are.
It might be, but I'm at peace with that.
You are at peace, John.
Yes, I'm at peace.
Well, why did you kill the girl?
I told you because I...
Because you what? Why? Why?
Because she...
Why?
Because she lied on me.
Did you not kill the girl?
Yes, she lied on me. I thought she loved me. She had me feeling like... Feeling like I was a big man. Walking around town, holding a white woman's hand. A fine ass white woman.
You could have been a big man.
For the first time in my life, I didn't feel like I was just black. Felt like a man. A big man. She lied on me and held a mirror to my face and showed me exactly what I am.
What is that now? What are you? What? Just to show you.
Just another nigga! Pop, you got to give it up. Let it go.
I can give you up. That's what I can do. I can let you up.
Nisi, Tanya.
There you go.
I love your fine ass too.
Red Bell.
Niece could never give me what you gave me, never.
I don't want to talk about that.
What do you mean, that?
King Henry II revisited some of the characters Wilson created for Seven Guitars, set 37 years earlier. King's mother, Ruby, pursued a career as a big band singer, so Louise raised King in her absence. In 1985, Louise had passed on, so King, who believed he was the natural son of King Henry, is married to Tonya, whose daughter Natasha is raising a child as a single mother.
King Henry spent 7 years in prison and had a vicious scar running down the left side of his face. He tried to make a living in a difficult environment. At the end of the play, King Henry learns that he is not King Henry's son, but rather the son of one of Ruby's early lovers. Violence erupts, and the play ends in heart-rending tragedy. Tonya! Don't walk away from me!
King, look where we
are! Answer me, what do you mean that? Tell me about that, the baby.
Let's not talk about that. Look where we are. I heard someone say that we can have
it. What did you say?
We can own something. We can build something together. Let's do that.
That's what we're doing. We're building a family together. Tonya, tell me about the baby.
Why are you always talking about
the
baby?
Was it a boy?
No.
Was it a girl?
No, listen, listen. We got potential here, King. We can build a life together. We can realize our dreams. Don't you want to do that?
I do. My dream is to have a family. With you!
It's not just about you, it's not just about a family, it's about my needs, your needs. Do you see that?
Everything I do is about your needs, our families.
August, you don't mind if I call you by your Christian name now, do you? You made me love this man.
And I love you.
And I do. But I have dreams as a black woman. I have aspirations and goals. I don't just want to be another baby's mama. Don't you understand that?
Not all you are.
Don't you understand that? Let's build a life together. Let's do something more than what we've done. This is a new beginning for us, King.
Yo, August, why did you make my life so miserable? You gave me the scar on my face. People won't even look me in the eye. Everything you did in my life was difficult. You never had anybody love me. It made me feel like dirt.
Okay.
Why? I got good soil. And I got a good seed. My seed could grow to be something good or change.
King, it ain't about soil. It ain't about seed.
What's it about?
Look at this. It's bone. It's durable. It'll last.
Nothing is stronger than family.
King.
Do you realize I never have nothing good?
Listen to me. I have a dream. I could be the next Whitney Houston. Listen, I got some talent. I'm every woman. It's all of me.
I'd rather hear you sing, "So you're having my baby." It means so much to me.
Really?
There's nothing more precious. That you raise a family.
Wait, listen.
If you didn't know, you can count on me.
King,
I'll never let you down.
I want you.
Please believe.
King, stop it.
In me.
Stop it.
Believe in me.
See me too.
I see you.
No, you
Everything
don't.
Everything I've done has been for you.
Everything you want me
for
is a baby's maker. King, I have needs. I want you to think about me. King, what if I said, Tonya, what you want to do tonight? Tonya, where you want to go to dinner? Tonya, Tonya, Tonya!
Tonya! Stop playing that you have that baby. Help me.
I can't have a baby now here. Couldn't have a baby then. I want to be a woman.
Tonya, I know I haven't done right by you. I know I'm a piece of shit. I never did nothing good.
We can be good together, just if you and I.
That baby, Tonya, was everything. That baby was innocent. That baby,
King,
is something good for once that I have in my life.
Let's make it about you and me. red sails in the sunset, way out on the sea. Oh, carry my loved ones home safely to me. He sailed at the dawning, all day I've been blue. Red sails in the sunset, I'm trusting in you. Swift wings we must borrow, make straight for the shore. We'll marry tomorrow.
From that community, making their fortune on their own without recognizing or acknowledging their connection to that large community. And I thought, we have gained a lot of sophistication, expertise, and resources, and we should be helping that community, which is devastated by drugs, crimes, and the social practices of the last 100 years. Radio Garth marked the fifth August Wilson play that Mary Ann Shirley Gray was the stage manager for. It was the first play that I worked with TAC. I played the role of Harmon Wilkes, a real estate developer in the Hill District running to be the first African-American mayor of the city of Pittsburgh. He is a descendant of Caesar Wilkes from Gem of the Ocean. His best friend and business partner, Roosevelt Hicks, is a bank vice president and the owner of a radio station. Joseph Barlow, born in 1918, is a descendant of Citizen Barlow and Black Mary from Gem of the Ocean. He's a current owner and resident of the house at 1839 Wallow, the source of conflict between Roosevelt and Harmon. We are trying to tear down that house to redevelop the neighborhood.
Roosevelt Hicks?
Oh, Harmon Wilkes!
Are you kidding me? What?
Good,
oh, man, it's good.
Yo, for old times.
time's sakes, we gotta do this.
Oh, you wanna go for church?
Old time's sakes.
Oh, what? Is he anywhere around?
Yeah, guess what? That nigga turned out to be my cousin, too.
Stop playing!
Yeah, wait. Joe Marlo! When did you meet this nigga?
Oh, okay.
Joe! Hey, what's up, guys?
How you doing?
Good to see you up here in the city.
Yeah, how you doing?
Oh, I'm wonderful.
Yeah, man, you know, I came to see you about that house on 1839 before we tore it down. Well, we wasn't going to tear it down.
I'm sure
after I met your ass.
That house is sanctuary. You can't tear that down. Yeah. That ain't subject to the laws of man.
But when I came there, you had already came into the city of Bones, so I didn't get the chance to find out about my rich family history there. But before you tell me something about that, I got somebody for you to meet.
You got somebody for me to meet?
Yeah, you remember my best friend who was like your thorn in your side?
Your best friend?
In the redevelopment office?
Yeah, I didn't like him.
Roosevelt Hill.
I didn't like him.
Yeah, well, you know, like him now.
Oh, how'd you get up in here?
Oh, come on, Mr. Everything clear, everybody happy. You know,
yeah.
Look, I was disrespectful on the side, I recognized that and realized that. So I figured, us being here and everything being all nice and everybody getting along,
yeah.
I just want to apologize to you, tell you how sorry I am, and hope that you'll accept my apology.
Tell me sorry.
I'm sorry.
You try to tear down my house, tell me you're sorry.
Girl, I made money. But I'm sorry.
Right. We ain't city bones.
Yes, sir. Yes, sir.
Glad you
thank you, brother. Thank you. Thank you so much. You crazy, man. I'll see you on
that. I didn't like it.
I know. You know, I always wanted to ask you. That house on 1839 Wally came real important. You know, I lost the race to become mayor of the city, and Maine left me and everything. And, you know, after that guy got shot in Ferguson, I actually went down and started helping with the Black Lives Matter, and then they shot my ass. That's how I got it. And now they're using their house for the Black Lives Matter.
I guess that house is sanctuary. Like I said, it's a place where the laws of man just don't matter. The laws of God matter there. But I got somebody I want you to meet.
Okay.
The blood is sticking in the mud. Remember that. Citizen, show on out there.
Joseph Barlow, my favorite grandson. How you doing, boy?
Oh, I'm doing wonderful.
I heard about how you saved Von Esther's house.
Oh, yeah, we did. We sure did.
Just wanted to let you know that I'm proud of you, son.
Oh, well, thank you. I got somebody I want you to meet, though.
Who's this fellow? He looks like he could be a Wilkes.
A Marvin Wilkes.
Get out of here.
Yeah, Marvin Wilkes.
I'll be. I knew your great-grandfather, Caesar Wilkes.
Yeah.
He was the brother of my wife, Black Mary Wilkes.
Hmm.
So I guess we can.
What was about this house on 1839 Wally that was so important to our family and our community?
It's a lot of history in there. That house was a stopping point that people used to gather at on their way up to the north from the south.
Hmm.
It's also where I first got my soul washed in. Brought here into the City of Bones for the first time. Also, a good friend of mine passed away there. A man by the name of Solitude Kings gave me this lucky piece of iron here, along with a walking stick that I used to continue on his mission after he passed.
Right, walking stick?
Yes. Carried it up with me all up and down the back roads and side roads. Coming about the South, leading people up to Freedom Land.
You know what? think I have something for you that belongs to you. The stick was just passed down to me.
I never thought I'd see this again.
Well, here it is, and I think our community still needs this stick. But I think maybe you should bless it, man.
Each one of these notches here?
Yeah.
That was a soul that got led up out of bondage, up into freedom. Mr. Solid Two Kings, he added 62 of these notches, started out.
Yeah.
I tried to add a few myself in my time. It looks like when I passed it on to my children, it looks like somebody else kept up the good work. Glad to see it then.
Yeah.
Continued on. You see that, Mr. Wilson? That right there is Mr. Solid Two King's stick. Gone full circle. He beat off some vicious dogs and even more vicious men with this stick, leading people up to freedom. And they've gone up, passed on to the generations, gone full circle, right here to the City of Bones. What's that? Sankofa?
Sankofa?
I never heard that term before, Mr. Wilson. What's that mean? Return to the origin.
Return to the origin?
Well, it's beautiful. I guess it means all things return back to their original origin. Full circle. The process continues. You know what? If all things return to the origin, Sankofa being the way it is, this actually belongs to another man. This still belongs to Mr. Solid Two Kings.
Solid Two Kings, you think he's here?
I know he's here. Solid! Solid Two Kings!
Talking about that Christian band, I belong to the band, hallelujah.
Hey! Solid.
Yeah, that's good.
I got this fella here I want you to meet.
Hey, how you doing?
I'm wonderful, how are you?
Right. This is Harmon Wilkes.
Wilkes?
Yeah, Harmon Wilkes.
Like you related to Caesar Wilkes?
Yeah, that was my great-great-grandfather.
Oh yeah, he won a shot. Well, I don't see him around here, so that's good.
This fella right here, he ran for the first black mayor of Pittsburgh.
Well, he did. Did you win?
Nah.
Oh, that's all right. You can run for the first black mayor of the City of Bones. How about that?
In the process, though, he was able to help my grandson, Joseph, save Aunt Esther's house back there in Pittsburgh.
Yeah, it's part of the Black Lives Matter movement now.
That's very important. I'm glad you did that, son. I really appreciate that.
I also learned a new term today. Mr. Wilson here taught me a word called Sankofa.
Sankofa.
Sankofa means return to the origin. And if all things are returning to the origin, this stick right here belongs back with you. It's got a few more notches in it, Solid.
62 people I led to freedom with this stick. And there's plenty more room. But if we're talking about going back to the origin, then I need to talk to Mr. Wilson. We're going to be all right, right?
Yeah,
we're going to be
all right.
Mr. Wilson, just want to thank you for giving us life and creating this City of Bones for us to dwell in. And we have to move on now. And well, you got to move on too. I know we brought you here with the Jubilee celebration, but we're going to lead you out with an even bigger celebration.
Oh.